Alrighty guys, hello and welcome back for more Space Soldiers vs. Kinguin here on ECS Championship Season 3. My name is Tom Pickering, online persona, we free men. Going straight into knife round on Inferno. Strangely, this is Space Soldiers map pick. Also, HLTV decides to tell me, and so far, I mean, just looking back at the facts, why I say it's interesting is they've only won 4 maps out of, I think it's like, what, 17? And that could be the old one mixed in as well. Kinguin, though, looking pretty healthy. They've got a 90% win rate. Played about 10 maps on here. Biggest win, I think, was 16-4 against Rogue. Going straight into the best round, though, Furling going to be pushing straight towards second win. Interesting. Look to take down Oxantara, so it's not going to happen, like Mihu. He's going to be the man to try and get the trade to go. Peeks around, takes a headshot. Looking for the trade. Major comes in towards mid out Malzinia. Going to be facing straight up against him. Gets away with his life, though. Kallax here. Beginning towards the bombers. Might not expect that. The bomb's going to get dropped. The information has come out. The smoke as well going to be trying to trap that down. The shots through the smoke is going to have to come out. Sparrow needs to peek around here. The bomb is not recovered. Sparrow, though, going for the desperate shots here. He'd be better off just picking up the bomb. I don't even think his body exposed there. It is recovered, but only just. Major, he's going to be down to 34 HP, but Paz, he's going to be able to take down Mihu right down to none as he headshots him. And look at that, Sparrow's going to get spotted out. Paz doesn't quite see if he's dropped down. Unfortunately for him, that's going to be his downfall if he's not careful. He doesn't see him. He turns around just in time to get the headshot as Major is a drop side 2-on-2 situation. Defuse getting not in the hands of the CTs here. Vraylin coming in from long, looking for the frags, takes them. Despy going to get dropped. The bomb in pit. Malzinho now has the information, looking to push aggressively in towards apartments. 25 HP left on Paz. It's going to be a little bit desperate here. He goes, picks up the bomb. He's not going to get challenged there. Potentially just playing hide and seek might be the best mode here, but he's going to get spotted out. Tags him slightly, but Marzinho coming in from apartments going to be able to drop him. And also, wonderful face have decided to host me, so welcome everyone. Didn't quite spot that, but I did say who I was. My name's Tom Pickering, aka Wafferman, taking part in the CCC, the Community Caster Challenge. First map, Inferno. This is a Space Soldiers of a pick. We're going to be seeing the SMG meta, the UMP meta. 4 of them plus an MP9. And then we'll be seeing Space Soldiers going in for the Tech 9-1. Obviously very powerful in its own regards. UMPs, though, much better. Or better. Sparrow here holding over towards long. Got the smoke out, ready to cut off that mid push if they do decide to push in there. The bomb is still going down to second mid. They're not being player too aggressive, but looking up behind them, Raylan. He's got MP9. He's not got too much to lose if they pick that up against armored players. It's not going to be too effective. But look at this, though. Push in towards short is coming out from the T's. They're not going to get taken down at all. But look at that. Malzinho, he's going to get taken out. No pressure at all. Kalex straight onto Mihu. 2 CTs down. No T's have been dropped. Quite low HP, but no kills. Another frag might be coming out. Despy going head on with these 2 CTs. Flash coming out from Paz. Doesn't quite work as perfectly as he had wished. But they shut down the CTs there. That was a fantastic execute. And you can start to see why Space Soldiers have come back and picked this map, even with the loose streak they have. Look at this, like MP9 player. He's going to get dropped. Kallax doesn't care. He doesn't want it. Furling gets a kill onto Despy, but that's the first T2 drop so far this round. You know, look at the economy. Looking a little bit bare here for Kinguin. If only picking up 1 kill and that player then getting dropped. It's actually Furling who has stayed alive, so 3 T's are very low on HP, but Mage is going to be able to pick up that UMP as well, so that's going to be a nice savings the next round. Won't have to spend any cash, apart from for utility, which is going to come out. Now Kinguin, we're going to be looking to force into this round, drop a few pistols out over towards their colleagues, and they're going to have to try and force this back. 4 UMPs, why not? They're going to be facing up against a 2 UMP and a 2 AK-47 setup, and Despy with that Tech 9 still lethal. 1-1 on the scoreboard here, going into the third round. Still in the default rounds here. It's very back and forth. The grenade doing a lot of damage, though. Mage is going to get dropped to 76 HP. Aggression coming into towards apartments. Paz land that jump, making no noise either. So the CT should have no indication of where he is at. Until he decides to do this jump, which I think it might be falling down, though. He is just waiting. And that's the sound indication. The CT is needed. Raylan going to be a key player here, but that smoke has failed. So is that flashed? Completely blinds this teammate. If they push around the corner there and they weren't flashed, could end up completely screwed. The man, look at that though. Xantar is going to take advantage. Drops further into 54 HP. This whole form of rain is going to be very crucial if they do decide to push. But the bomb holder is going to go in towards B apartments. B apartments? T apartments. Close to that, is right? That's B holding mid with the Tech 9. What a fantastic long range weapon there. He'll be countering that flash from Sparrow, but it's not going to affect him. He has backed off. Leaving long bear. Good choice, considering that we're going to be rushing down there. Kallax takes down Marzinho. First frag of this round. It's all going to be down to Sparrow here to counter them. Pushing over towards Long. He's going to be able to drop no one as AK-47 does its work. The rotation not quite going to come in. We do have a player sneaking up behind them. That is going to be Major. He's got 76 HP. He was grenaded originally. Pushes straight out to the side. He's going to get spotted and a drop. That's going to be the first frag out from the CT side. Taking down Major. So even with that kill, still got no money in back. If they do manage to save these three weapons, they are going to be able to stack up onto a site, try and save into the following round, and so on and so forth. But then just going to be picking up the UMP here. So that's three UMPs in the next round. Molotov coming out. Not really going to be doing too much. Let's just say that Renan is dropped down to 69 HP. Not to get pushed on too aggressively. Space do not want to lose their economy. They're going to take the second round. They can have quite a bit of cash in the bank, but they have to keep that up. They can't get sort of taken down and flooded by the CTs here. You are going to be going in for this partial buy on two of the players. That's going to be Marzinho and Spiro, but we're going to be seeing the pistols come out on them. One Tech 9 dropped over to Marzinho, so some cash saved up there. Three UMP players. It's interesting that we are going to be seeing Marzinho and Spiro over towards the A site, stack up the three UMP players over towards B. And Zantara's here with the Tech 9. That's a AK-47. Slightly different gun. Going to be peeking them over towards B. Zantara's here looking to push up. He's going to get the spray down, but the trade comes in instantaneously. But Zantara's, even after death, is going to be able to take down Ferlin. And we're going to be down to Alex. He's going to be doing some damage, but not too much. As Sparrow's going to be able to make away with his life. 57 HP on the board. Paz looking to end in here. There's only three CTs left alive. One of them has armor. The rest of them do not. They've only got pistols. So can't really take too much damage. And as soon as they're shot, that's going to be the accuracy going everywhere. So Sparrow going to be peeking into his apartments up against Kallax. He's just holding this angle though. Waiting for them to walk straight into his 5-7. And bang, one tap. Nothing though. The T's have just taken their time here. 47's left on the clock. Fate coming out over towards A. Rotation from CT's has happened. But they're not going to be meeting anything here. The T's are looking to go over towards B and slay anyone that was there, but they've all rotated, so it's all safe for the T's to just plant the bomb over towards Coffins, set themselves up, and it's pretty much an impossible retake situation for Team Kingwin. Not impossible, implausible, but look at this. So, the Major is going to be able to drop Balzino, peeking around the corner, going up against Raylan. He's going to get traded out. UMP going to get dropped, though. Raylan going to get taken down. Despy gets the trade out. Looking for the last kill. Sparrow here might walk into the crosshairs. 5 seconds. And now on the floor as he gets killed. So as we go into the fifth round, we are going to be seeing Space Soldiers take the lead. Three rounds on the board in a row. Doing a fantastic job here. Now Team Kingwin, kind of lackluster. They've got the full buy-up this round. Utility's pretty good as well. Raylan got full armor. Rest of them partial. Really the way it should be going against this full AK-47 buy-up. The bomb though has been left behind over towards T-Spawn, so they're going to have to keep an eye on this. It's going to be down to a few of the T's. Alexandra's going to be peeking in, looking for damage. Raylan is going to get tapped down through the smoke, but he stays so calm and stays alive. That was so close. Look at this. Zantara still pushing up pretty aggressive. Berlin in the wrong crosshairs. He's going to get sprayed down to low HP. Does a little bit of damage, though, but they're going to get dropped. Grenade coming in. Major. an Exantris on quite low HP. Spirio looking to peek in from the corner. He's going to be facing straight up against an Exantaris and might get slain here. Major still on the hiding peek in the corner, but as he peeks, he's going to get dropped. Major, nice trade out there. As he is over towards A, looking to make his way in here. But unfortunately for him, there's a boosted player. Mikey, he's going to be able to get the kill as Paz is dropped. And that's going to be a 3v3 situation. Two players on each side have been slain. So we're going to be down to these T's to try and go on a 3-on-2 situation over towards the A site. Enter in through balcony, enter in through boiler. Can we make those high-impact kills? Talk about high-impact kills! Kalix manages it, but only just as he dropped down 7 HP. Now Mazzunio, the flash coming in from the side angle. He is. Flash, but gets the kill onto Xantaris. The drop comes in. He hears it. He takes one. Not quite the second one, as Kalix is going to be able to slay Mazzunio. It's going to be down to a 1v1. The pressure's building. Sabara, though, he's got 4 HP. 6 seconds left on the clock. Bomb goes down. Sabara knows where he is. Can't escape off the site now. He's got no utility, no defuse kit. Sprays through that box, that could be the end of it. Kalix has now heard him. He's got the peak position. He's going to get peaked. The spray through the box could happen. Just drop him here. He's going to get shot. The headshots are not coming out. Eventually, he's going to get dropped, but that's not even a headshot there. It's the first round in quite a while coming out from Team Kinguin. Game was as good as they had really wished. A lot of them just got wiped out there. That they'll play down banana when multiple of the CTs were sitting on the other smoke, on the other side of the smoke, goes Raylan and Ferlin, and they're taken down so low on their HP. And I think it was Raylan or Ferlin who managed to move out of that position, eventually dropped though, for Xantaris. It's going into the next round, it's going to be the sixth round. This could be the point where Kinguin could take the equalizer back and take this round by storm, but it's not going to be easy. A space soldiers have got the full buff. They got the AWPA on Despy. He's done some crazy shots before me, who are going in the same boosted spot. So be careful doing that, because that could easily be red. Okay, Alex. He is going up in towards apartments. Joining Paz here. The bomb, though, is over towards Banana. They have boosted up as well onto that wall in the Banana, trying to sort of gain as much sort of knowledge as possible. Total of knowledge, here, going to be able to read the situation nicely as they try to push out. He should be able to look away, peek back, for our own upon them. But Paz here just playing patiently, 1 minute left on the clock. I think Space Soldiers were up for a challenge. They didn't have the advantage going into this one. The second map will be Cobblestone. I think they can perform very well on there. They've got I think it's 66% win rate on there. Over 50 games played, I think 57 or like 58 or maybe even 60 now. Pretty good win ratio. Same could be said for Kinguin though. I think it's near close to 30 games as well. About 60% win rate. Looks like Spear is going to be facing up against him. He's going to be able to execute Major straight away. Me coming in from behind, going to be able to drop Xantaris. The spray coming in from Paz. Execute Sparrow. It's all going to be down to me here in this position to try and drop Despy. He's got the AWP, but Paz going over towards Log. He's going to be facing straight up against a player in Library. Raylan going to be able to drop one. Kalix going to get tagged down very low. 9 seconds left on the board. He's going to have to run home. Run, Forest, run. Life is a box of chocolates. Know when to pick your battles. You never know which one you'll win. That doesn't even make any sense, but hey-ho, references galore. Love them or hate them, they're going to be made. Kinguin take the equalizer round and really trying to recover their stance here. We are going to be seeing Kalix save into this round. He's going to be able to have that AK-47. Two Tech 9s, a Deagle, and some utility coming out from the T side as well. Paz, he's got that Tech 9 and some armor. That's going to make some difference as he looks to push in towards some apartments here. Sorry, he's going to be able to get the first kill. Kalix taking the trade onto Mihu as he pushes down mid, punished for his greediness, but Raylan, he's left completely unopposed here as he pushes down Banana along with his buddy there, Ferlin. Ferlin and Rallin. Smoke comes out. Sparrow has AWP. Despy's going to get dropped. The second trade. No, trade comes out from Xantaris. Strikes down Ferlin. 1 minute 20 still left on the clock. 3v3 situation. There's a 3 rifles now recovered for the T side. I think it might well be, as Ferlin was dropped and Xantaris had also picked up the M4 from down mid. I think Paz has actually picked up the gun yet. There you go, he's going to be going down. Picks up the AK-47, fantastic. Look at this though, Raylan, he's on the other side of that box. Are they going to realize he's going to have to peek on the corner? No, he's going to get dropped, and that's going to leave the B site completely open, guys. The rotation is coming in, but is it going to be soon enough? AWP and M4A1, some utility, no smokes. One single grenade, two defuses. Now that's important. One very low player on the T side. Spam coming in, Sparrow with the grenade, but it's the wrong position. They're not waiting there. They know you might well just do that. And the save's coming out. Kingwin had realized they've dropped the ball in this. And they're going to get erased from this round here, if they're not careful. So they are going to back off, save these two guns. Quite an expensive setup there. I mean, the AWP, $4,750. That's not easily recoverable. But if they do save these, they might be able to force up into the next round. But they might just save up again. We've seen it from them before with the UMP play, where they had three of the UMP players save the three UMPs. It's not going to say UMP in one sentence. And that actually ended up working out for them. Not that well, though. So the point it did, we are going to be seeing the force come out, the Famous on Nihu, the M4A1 out on Raylan. Berlin, what's he going to be doing there? He doesn't have much cash. I think he was dropped. There you go, UMP in hand for him. So that's actually a really nice buy from them. Tease though, they've got the full AK-47 buy up. That's no M4, so they must have traded that up. Interesting. Oh yeah, there was actually Raylan who had the AK-47. He got dropped. That was recovered. The grenade coming down Banana, not doing too much damage. Major, looking to return the favor, rather. Drops it. Go here, shooting his own teammate. I'm not even sure what happened there. That is your buddy. Please don't love tap him. This game is for children, obviously. Sparrow, look at your radar. Stop it. I thought he was going to kill him then. Look at this peak, though. Major takes down Ferdinand as he pushes down Banana. Nice distraction coming in here. Raylan going to be going up against Major. Sprays through the smoke. He's going to be able to try and get the frag. Not quite going to be able to execute it correctly, though, as they're going to be able to back off. And Zantaris here looking to find the finish here. Right onto Raylan. It's not going to come out, though. Sparrow peeking in through CT. He's got the AWP, got the angle as well. The smoke's faded, but it's going to get dropped again. Three CTs over towards the B site. Quite a good call, but unfortunately, it's the wrong one. We're going to be seeing the push over towards A come out any moment, and it's all going to be down to the man, Malzinho. The flashes, the smoke's going to be coming out. The Molotov, though, return from him. He's going to be dropping it down. He's going to be returning. Sparrow takes down Major. Has frag, finds it. Malzinho going to get executed. Centaurus pushing in towards CT. It's going to be down to Raylan to face up against him. But as we're going to be seeing this, Sparrow, he's going to get dropped. Xalantaris' position has been given away, but 2 versus 4. It's going to be very hard for these guys to be able to pull this off. Especially with Zantaris just playing a very sneaky sort of position here. He's done exactly that. He's just in library. His position hasn't been noticed. Pushes on the site, takes down Paz. Look at this, like, he takes another one, but Zantaris going up from behind, takes him down. There's going to be left in a 1 versus 2. Famous in hand. He looks to find the frag. Zantaris peeking around the corner. He's going to get the drop, and that's going to be the final kill of this round. A total wipeout there. A little bit embarrassing as well. Some team damage coming on very early. Dropping Sparrow. Dropping one of the teammates down to 64 HP. Sparrow being a little bit trigger happy. Love tapping his buddy. Grenade coming out on Raylan. Are they going to go for a grenade strap? Seems like one of them are. One of them is, rather. CZ in the hands of Raylan as well. He's going quite far into this one. That would be quite nice to save that cash. But why not? He's going to be over towards B. Drops the grenade. Does a healthy amount of damage. I mean, 15 damage off of Zantaris. Why not? It's only 5 rounds on the board for Space Soldiers. Remember, this isn't their map pick. This is Kingwin's. And Kingwin did previously do a 16-4 against Rogue. So probably felt very confident on the CT side on what they can perform. At the moment, they're getting shut down. P250 in the hands of Sparrow. Didn't quite notice that he has got that gun at that distance. Could one-tap Zantaris. The push-up, though, Raylan with the CZ. They're so close. As soon as the peak comes out, he could get dropped. So could they. They've got no armor, no head armor. As long as they can try and keep down the economy on the side of Kingwin, look very healthy for them. Execute, getting set up here. For the B side. Best B. Gonna be launching the first one. Miko into mid, takes down Major. That's gonna be a grenade dropped in Zantaris. Looking to push in here. You're gonna have to try and find the frags. Molotov is going to shut them off as well. Going in for the tap, it's not going to happen. He's going to get dropped through the smoke. It's going to be down to these last two players, and Tyre's going to get dropped by Ferlin through the smoke. The trade comes out. Despy takes down Raylan. It's not a 3-on-3 situation. Alzenio picks up the AK-47 from mid. They're going to go and save that. And it's all going to be down to Ferlin there to try and do some damage. He might well be able to do it. These shots are missing. Despy takes him down to 6 HP, but going to be good enough. The P250 going to be recovered. We're going to be seeing him peek in through construction. He has been heard. He goes around the corner. Going to get dropped. Not going to quite take that frag for himself. Miku has been spotted. He's going to get dropped. Malzinho here over towards the library looking to save this gun. And that will allow them to force up into this next round. That'll be 3 rounds lost in a row for Team Kinguin. Taking the Space Soldiers 3 rounds ahead of them. Though saying that, we might actually see Kalex there find the dragon. He does. He drops Malzinho. No AK-47 for you, he says. Learn to be still. If he'd stayed in that position in the library, he would have stayed alive. He was too impatient and tried to find the final murder on the Space Soldiers to try to get some exit frags. Nah, he was actually trying to escape. Unfortunately for him, they were playing quite aggressive and hunting him down. Kalex going in for the blood. So we are going to be seeing the food bar coming out from Kinguin, spending every little bit of cash they can into this round. All flashes. Defuse kit on Raylan, UMP on him as well, so he went for the utility buy instead of just the M4, always nice to see. Sparrow holding over towards shore here, no open hand, he's not going to do some team damage, I hope. T's not holding that banana at all, so if they got pushed on that, that would actually be horrendous for them. I think they have got that sorted, that smoke delaying any kind of confidence play from Kinguin. Which, if they had done that, just played off confidence and just pushed through that smoke, this could have been their round. But ifs and buts. Can't really do too much as the XP comes down. We're going to be seeing Paz take the frag onto Sparrow. A nice trade off there. Now Malzinho is going to go head on to head with Kalex getting his revenge. Miku here in the smoke. Drops Major. That's the murder he was wanting. He's looking over towards Short. Takes one. Takes a second. That's going to be a massive 3k for the man. Going huge this round. Picking up an AK-47 for his trouble. Not quite as he was. Not quite quick enough. The drop comes in. We've got 2 AK-47s on Team Kinguin's side. That's 2. That's 1 UMP, not 2. 2 M4s. 1 UMP, 2 AKs. Space Soldiers, they're actually going to be on their last buck here. So are the CETs. So this is a nice round for them to have. Could be a nice reset. The grenade coming in down mid. Doesn't really do anything major, though. Going to get dropped to 73 HP very early on in the round. They've got a lot of sulfur area control here down banana, but that grenade going to do tremendous damage. Dropping Zarin Taurus. But the second one, taking him down to 45 HP even. Despy here. He's desperate for a kill. Peeking around the corner. If he just holds his position, Raylan draws straight into his crosshair, and he's going to get dropped. And now the second one comes out. That flash kill being fantastic from Despy as he slays them. As they tried to push around the corner way too confidently. Kalex pushing in through apartments. The bomb is still over towards T. Despy going to be able to get the kill. Kalex over towards the A site looking for his revenge frag. Over towards Malzinho. Peeks out, takes it down. And that's going to be finished and neutralized. Spiro over towards Long. He's going to be the last man standing in a 1v5 situation. Kalex 1, kill on the board. Despy 2, 3 even. I think he's going for a revenge frag here. Going in towards apartments. Kalex going to be backing off. He looks at the wrong position and gets fragged there. Looks in towards the balcony room. Kalex comes in from the side angle from corridor. Drops him like a fly. Space Soldiers taking the lead here. 7 rounds on the board. Looking to take the 8th and half win. Team Kinguin going to be looking to not give it to them, but make it a bit easier. As they've only got 4 rounds on the board, and they're going to be going into a partial buy. 2 P250s, 1 CZ, 1 5 7. And very little utility. Going to be railing once again, buying up that utility. See, had saved some extra cash last round. Yeah, going to have to back off that Molotov. Going to be able to burn him if he doesn't back off in time. He is, though. Alzenio holding this nice angle, but push for him. Paz is having none of it. Drops him. He's not going to continue on that catfight between him and Kalex. Paz is saying, stop your silly games. I'm murdering for you. Now Zantaris takes down Raylan. Ferlin is going to get dropped as well as Paz does take down Mihoyo into Wall's Boiler, leaving it Sparrow in 1 versus 5. Doesn't really stand a chance there. As Paz picks up a nice 3k in that partial buy. Now let's see if Team Kanguin can eradicate Space Soldiers on this next round. Fortunately for them though, they're going to be very far behind in regards to the economy. Raylan going to have to go in for the full daredevil move here. Glass Cannon, AWP, no pistol to back him up, no utility. Just going all in here. He's going to be holding at that coffin area. The boost coming out with towards Short Sparrow. Boost numbers teammate. No real aggression coming in here until the push through apartments comes out. There we go. Paz in there once again. Sparrow here has got the Mag 7. Nice counter gun for this position. Zatara's playing at this B angles perfectly. He's won most of the firefights down there. Really been able to dispatch any of the CTs who decide to try and push on him there and get the revenge fags, but they are going to give that up. They're not going to be playing aggressively there. They're going to opt in to go towards A. This might be a mistake in itself. The flash comes out, but Mihoyo is going to get dropped. He's held that angle way too many times, and he's going to get punished. Saying you're read too easily, but look at this. Burrow takes down Kalix. He's going to be able to pick up the AK-47. Paz looking in for the trade kill. Peeks around the corner. He's going to be able to execute him. That's going to be another frag on the board for the T's. 4 versus 3. Not so good for Kanguin here. Ferlin going in for the rotation. Raylan going to be holding B-site alone. He has armor. No armor, sorry. And an AWP. The T's are rotating as well. Ferlin going to be dedicating himself through a library. And he's going to be facing straight up against Major. And that distance is going to be very hard for him. Look at this. Tartarus takes a frag. Raylan dropping the ball. Completely unexpected that push. Now Ferlin looking to hold over towards Arch. As he knows Major is around this area, might go in for the rotation. He's going to be pushing in nonetheless. He looks at the wrong corner. Is he going to be able to get the frag? He runs at the wrong position. Major. Going to be able to wipe him out. Once again, Malzinho looking to go in for the save, but how is he going to be able to do this? I mean, he failed it before. Major looking in for the kill. They can just drop their guns. They don't care. They've got enough cash to buy into the next round, so they just want to try and stop the save coming in here. The kill comes in. The rotation from that position is going to happen from Malzinho. He can't stay in that same one. And he's going to do it, but he has to stop making the noise. And Tyrus looking to peek around the corner. I don't think he quite spotted that barrel, however long it is there. Paz coming in from Palmer's as well. Having to watch this dual angle is going to be very difficult. Paz exposing himself. He's been seen. He's going to get frags. And Tyrus coming out from below. Dropping him. And we're going to be seeing Malzinho pushing up daisies there. Although I don't think they were daisies, guys. So I've just checked, and HLTV has now been up. There we go. Yeah, so Soldiers, yeah, obviously picked Inferno. They haven't got as good history on this map, but they have got this map under their belt right now. 9 rounds on the row. On the board. Kanguin with only 4, they're going to be partially buying up into this round, trying to wipe out the T side, but it's going to be very hard here. 2 CZs, 1 P250, 157. Despy playing very passive here, down second mid. Waiting for them to push him, and look at this. Ferlin going straight on against them, drop down quite low. It's 83 HP with no armor, that is quite low. Look at this, though, headshot. To come out, but Paz is going to get dropped to 2 HP. What fantastic play coming out from the CTs, but not good enough. Xartaris pushes aggressively, loses 30 HP, but eventually gets 2 frag. This push comes in, but Major's going to get dropped. That flash was not in his favor. AK-47 recovered. The save looking to come in. Malzinho trying to be the save king here, but it's failed twice so far. Is it going to happen again? But this time he has got 2 teammates, Mew and Sparrow, there to back him up in case they try to push him. Holding both sides of the map as well. But Despy's having none of it. He's just going to wait. They're going to have to check their corners because Malzinho, he's going to have backed off. It's going to be down to Mew here. He's going to be peeking around the corner. Takes down Zantaris. Picks up an AK-47. He's going to be backing off. And look at that. Sparrow taking down Kalix. Shutting down these corners. And Malzinho looking to back him up, going in for the trade frags. This could work fantastically here. Paz looking around the corner. He might just get slain here. He's only got 2 HP. Sparrow needs to push in, pick up the gun. He takes one. Looking for the trade. It's not going to happen. Sparrow takes him on and drops him. That's going to be another kill on the board for Space Soldiers, as well as another round. And so much cash in the bank, they don't care. They just didn't want to drop any more money or guns over to Team Kanguin. Look at this, Ferlin. He's going to be flying over towards B. This has been talked about a few times. Going for the spam behind. He's going to position himself right behind those coffins. Actually, no, it's through that wall, isn't it? He's just going to sit there and spam through here. Craft recently. Major doesn't care, but the smoke pushes through. The smoke flash coming out. Team flashing himself. Sparrow gonna be regretting that. Short push coming out. Mihu hits in on those boxes. Mazzino over towards the balcony. He's gonna get spotted. He gets the kill. Trade though. Paz takes down Mihu. It's gonna be a 4-3, but look at that. Mihu Ren takes on 1. Not looking so healthy here. Mazzino gonna be able to take down Helix, even in a 3-2 situation. Further, no armor though. Paz on this angle, looking for the spray for the will, takes it. That is a beautiful angle right there. Gonna be able to execute Malzinho. Raylan pushing in. He's got the AK-47. He's got the defuse kit. The shot misses. Further, he's left Raylan in a very difficult situation here. 1-2. Defuse kit in hand though. The wall bang's coming in. He's been spotted. The frag is missed. SB looking for the second one. He doesn't quite land it. He can't quite find the kill. So Raylan going in for the flashes here, the counter smoke. He knows it's going to be very hard for him to do anything here. Yeah, he's got a second smoke though. He's also got a defuse kit going to come in. Major help here. Smoke coming out. Not even quite sure where that was from. Paz looks for the spot, doesn't quite take him on. Chucks out the molly. We now know where one of the players is. Ray comes in. But now it's going to be down to Despy. He misses his shot, and that is a clutch situation coming out from Raylan. Taking on two players head on there. Very well played from the man. And even though he clutched that, that's only going to bring them to 5 rounds. This is where they need to stomp Space S. Really wipe them off the top of the map. Make them regret going up against Team Kinguin. The Polish team tonight. And obviously Space S. Oh, Space Soldiers, going to be the Turkish team, doing a fantastic job here. Going to go up against Team Kinguin, who obviously have just found out that their home country is going to be hosting their next major. That's going to be some awesome work. I'm going to be going straight into this round. Defuse kit and grenade in the hands of Despy. Otherwise, they've got armor. Tease, they've got 1 flash. That's it. Smoke as well. It's going to be going out. The short push is going to be coming. No long, actually. Now Major going to hold them. Hold this corner. Takes down 2 frags. The bomb going to get dropped. Raylan going to have to recover this. Major going to be pushing straight into his crosshairs. He's going to get taken down. It's now going to be down to these last 2 Ts in a 2-on-5 situation. First CT dropped. 3 CTs stacked over towards Long. Look at this. Antares has spotted him. He flicks straight into his head. Doesn't quite land it though. Raylan stuck in towards mid. Taking on that 1v1 situation. It's going to quite work. Mihu pushes down. He's going to get taken down. Leaving Raylan once again in a clutch situation. But they know exactly where he's at. They could put the pressure on him where it hurts. Paz making the foot sounds. He is going to get tagged, but not enough as he is going to get the drop onto Raylan. That's going to be him executed. Guys, remember, my name is Tom Pickering, aka We Free Men. You're going to be seeing a lot more of me around, guys, as we're going to the second round. T is going to be forcing up. CTs are going to be countering it with almost the same buy at that space as Team Kinguin had. But the M4 in the hand of his Antares there. Now, Paz peeks down. Banana takes Sparrow straight down. Headshot, body shot, quick and easy. Mazzini and Mihu are going to be dropped down quite low as well. Tech 9, P250 in their hands. May just push it down straight into Malzarino's peak. And Malz gets the drop. Paz, though, goes in for the trade. Very nice here. Mihu holding down into Boiler. He's not going to get pushed on here, but Ferlin does get tagged down to 79 HP. Zara's holding that angle with the M4. The push over towards Long has come out here. The bomb dedicated. Kalix looking to push through. He could flash through. Despy, though, he's got the MP9. He's going to get taken down. The P250 proving a little bit too strong. Kalix looks to peek around the corner. He's going to get dinked and eventually drop. Ferlin going huge here. Looking to have to take straight on with his Antares. He's only got 6 bullets in the mag. Takes the frag. The third headshot of the P250. And they're going to be able to go drop the bomb. It's going to be a 1-2 situation. Paz. He's got no defuse kit here. They don't know where he is, though. That's his current advantage, his only advantage in this situation. He has got incendiary grenade, but trying to position that well is not going to work, as we have got Mishu and Mihu, who are just playing very passive in towards. Paz takes on one. Finally gonna get dropped. Looking for the second kill. He could actually take this. He knows where the player is. He could chuck down the incendiary grenade. But Mio gets the frag. And that's gonna be the clutch coming out in a 1v1 situation. But Paz doing a fantastic job to recover it from a 1v2 to a 1v1. Eventually gonna be able to take him down, but Zantara's is M4 not gonna be recovered. It's gonna be left on that site to cower away. Because it was a house gun, you know. Fantastic puns. 6-11 on the board in favor of Space Soldiers. We're going to be seeing them force up into this round. One Deagle, one CZ, 157, two UMPs, and some utility. No defuse kits, though. On the other side, we're going to be seeing three UMPs, two AK-47s, and a buttload of utility as well. The flashes coming in from both their sides, though. Team flashing and also enemy flashing does work. Paz going to get mollied back off. He gets tagged down to 85 HP. Nice starting damage there. Is coming in. The spray from the smoke comes in. Mage is going to get dropped down to 20 HP. No, he's not going to get away with it. He is going to get executed as Furlan sprays there with the AK-47. Even more so in the advantage of Team Kinguin here. They need every advantage they can get here. They win the first round. They need to win the next and last default round. The force worked out on the second default round, but to really sort of carry this through, they have to win the final default round, buff up their economy, and also their wins, because they've only got 6, they need 7. This beacon and pushing towards B is coming out. Paz is going to expose. He gets a headshot, not quite the kill though. Brandon going to get dropped down quite low. He peeks. Brandon getting his revenge. Mio straight onto Despy though. It's going to be a 2v5 situation. The Molotov coming out. Furlan doesn't really get too much damage done to him though. Zantara and Kalex, last two players left alive. And they're just going to be backing off here. They've got armor, they've got pistols. Might as well save them into the next round where it is going to be a partial buy or just a full eco from Space Soldiers. No real kills are going to be coming out onto these two players. Team Kinguin, if you have a look at their economy, they need to save every single bit they can alongside Space Soldiers having to do exactly the same. It's 5-7 in the next round. Could it equal easy one or two kills around the corners. As long as you're just holding the right position as the CT, that gun is OP. Same with the CZ. Nowhere near as OP as a CZ used to be. That was crazy. The reload time was almost instantaneously. Almost instantaneous. I can't even say that. Round 19, advantage still in the hands of Space Soldiers. They've not won a round since the first pistol round on this half. We are going to be seeing them go for the full eco on three other players. They've not really got much money to spare. Kinguin is going to be able to run into this in the round with all their guns, but not anymore. Zantara takes them down with the deagle in hand. Wandy's Mihu down in towards mid. Looking to blaze them down. P coming in through balcony from the man himself. It's not going to happen as the push comes in towards B. Major of the USB looking for the spray. Not going to happen though. He's going to have to back off as the mollies are coming in. But the spray comes in. Bay is going to do Panzer Brother. Good, doing a fantastic job. Now Sparrow pushing in towards construction. He does get blocked by that wall. Smoke is hard, you know. But no, he just pushed through this time. He gets one frag, two frags. Easy. Easy execute here. Going in for the third. He slays Kedix. Drops him right into the ground. Zantara so goes for his second frag. Looking even more this distance to Deagle is fantastic, but he's going to be able to pick up a third, not quite the fourth. He is going to get dropped as Sparrow is going to be able to pick up the 4k for himself. Seems like we have a lot of Turkish viewers tonight. Hello guys and welcome. So Centaurus is going to be currently on 20-10, leading the charge on the leaderboard. 10 frags in front of quite a few of the players actually on the board. Almost 10. Space Soldiers. Only a little bit lackluster here on the CT side. Buying up into this round is going to be a full M4 buy. Some utility. No defuse kits though. T side. Team Kinguin. They have upgraded one of the guns. Sparrow going to be picking up the AWP. They've got the full AK buy. Full utility as well once again. No UMPs inside sight for either side though. Because this is Space Soldiers map pick. Fantastic history on it, but they're looking to try and improve that team. Kinguin have done some brilliant games on it. Currently out of 10 games, they've won 9. One of them was against Team Rogue in a fashion, I think it was 16-4. I think I'm right about it. But last round, Space did a fantastic job. I mean, with the Deagle coming out, he drops three players himself, and then one of the other players on the T side was dropped. So that's a lot of damage over towards the economy of Kinguin. They've still got enough to be able to do what they want. We're going to be seeing Mihu pushing in towards Boiler, looking for the aggression. He's going to be playing against Antares. That's not someone you want to be facing. Despio towards Long as well. The pressure's coming in, but the push has come out over towards B. Slowly but surely, they're looking to execute here. Major low, looking to peek around the corner. They might pull the pants down. He takes one, looking for the second. He goes in for almost three, but the slay comes back. He's going to get dropped now. Zantaris in the smoke. He's going to be peeking out towards mid. Drops Mihu. The instant 1v4 situation comes out, but look at this. Baron misses the shot. He's going to get pushed on here. Pad's going to go into the frag. Takes him down. With only Major getting dropped, that's going to be a fantastic result here for Team Space Soldiers. That's what we're talking about. Has taken himself to 20-10. Zantaris 21-10 himself. On the other side, we have Sparrow top fragging at 14-15. A little bit lackluster. Grenade coming out from the CT side. We have got four spike coming in from Team Kinguin. Two pistols, one UMP, one AK-47, and a AWP coming out from Sparrow. No armor though. Has to be careful. So banana control could come out from the CT side there, making some efforts for this speed. He's going to be able to drop Mew. It's going to be an AK-47 out of their control. Only one grenade on Ren to try and recover that distance. Look at this though. Berlin looking to peek around the corner. What's going to happen though? Major's just taking full control. I had mentioned this. They've done exactly that. The rotation has come in. They're taking control of this AK-47. They know that he's going to want to play for this. And cleverly, they've just left it. Flash comes in though, pushing Sparrow, but he's going to have to back off the incendiary grenade, just stopping them from being able to do anything here. If they could get that AK-47, it'd be fantastically useful, but fortunately for them, Zantaris has picked it up. The push in towards mid has come out, but passed from the wrong angle, takes down Raylan. The trade isn't there. Sparrow wasn't quick enough. He doesn't get the frag. It's going to be a 3-on-5 situation. Sparrow going to be pushing up nice and aggressive here, but unfortunately he's going to be going up against Palace. He's going to get flashed in, pushes in, looks to take two frags. He's going to be able to get the XQ here on these two players, wiping them out from the face of the map, and there's going to down to Mouse, who's going to go in a 1v5. Looks to take down, takes down Paz. Has no rifle though. He's going to be up against Major, who pushes him through mid, drops him. That's going to be another frag on the board and round for Team Space Soldiers. Round 13. And round 22 in total. Only 8 rounds on the board for Team Kinguin. Space Soldiers really showing us how it's done. We're going to be down to a partial buy coming out from Team Kinguin. They got the P250s, but not the distance or the right sort of positions, and Zantaris is going to be able to interrupt. Drops down Sparrow. Trade can't come out here. So Kennex takes on Mihu as the smoke doesn't even pop off. He didn't wait long enough. He goes in for the aggressive play. It's a little bit too slow. A little bit too slow or a little bit too aggressive. Make your choice. It was both. There's pushing towards mids coming out. Mage is going to be backing up the AWP player. He's going to be able to drop one. Looking for the second frag. It's not going to happen. Zantaris takes down Malzinho and is able to slay him. Space Soldiers just shutting them right down here, wiping them out. Quite a lot of that TV show, Wipeout. Team Kinguin here, doing half decently, get to 8 rounds, but Space Soldiers, proving a little bit too difficult here. That obstacle course is obviously proving a little bit too difficult for Team Kinguin. So we're going to be seeing the push down second mid coming out from Team Kinguin. We've seen them sort of try and hold this position before, but this time a lot more passively than usual. No pushing towards apartments. They're being punished for that. It's now going to come out slowly, slowly. Major's going to go straight down in towards T-Ramp. It does come up. No damage really from either side. They've got the positions. They've got this sort of push down banana as well. They have to try and waste out the utility from the CT side so they can gain the time. But look at this. The spray comes out. The flash as well blinds himself. Kallax spray from the door. Mew got that angle, drops him to 87, but Despi takes down Sparrow. That aggressive play, but look at this. Malzinho being around the corner, drops him. It's going to be the frag on this side. Mew going to get taken down to very low HP. Look for the aggression. Antares hasn't got the grenade. The flash coming out, though. Mihir's going to be dropped down to 14 HP. But Mihir has got the AWP. Mal's looking to peek around this corner. Paz, his head is going to be found. He's going to be slain. Mal's picking up for as long. He's got a lot of HP. Gets the frag as well. Major takes down Mihir. Mama monster kill! As Major takes down two, but Kandex joins in with the fray. He's going to be able to drop two in total. As Ferlin and Raylan not going to be proven difficult enough here. And I think that was a little bit godlike. Very nice plays coming out from Space Soldiers. Really playing as a team. Going in for the trades. And punishing for Kinguin for any of their mistakes. So when that really happens, you've got to wonder, like Kinguin, that they're not really playing properly for the trades here. They're trying to, but failing. Kallax. Grenade coming down. Not really going to be doing too much, though. Ferlin playing aggressive with the UMP. He's got the angle, he's got the push, but unfortunately for him, he's going to have to back off. Two CTs there, looking to go against them. Ferlin, he's going to be able to take down Major. The headshot coming out. It's going to get popped. Kallax. He looks to peek down. He's going to get taken down right into Bad Town. It's going to be downtown for this man, locked up in Zantaris. He's going to go in for the trade over for short. Sight in the end, as Mouse is very aggressive here. The bomb is still in the T's control. And so is the favor, actually. Look, listen, Zantaris looking to push down towards short. The smoke came out, but it's from the wrong side, and he knows they might be playing a little bit strangely here. Paz, he's going to be able to take down Berlin. The information is out. He's going to back off here. Despy, peeking around the corner, takes the frag onto Miku, but the trade comes in. Raylan, Sparrow going huge. They're going to be able to drop two of the CTs, leaving Zantaris here in a 1-on-2. What a way to finish this up. If he can clutch this out, he might just be seeing that godlike play I'd called earlier. Peeking around the corner, Raylan gets the frag, though, and that's going to be the round in the bag for Kinguin. For Space. They could force up into this one, but that would affect their economy quite badly. They're going for it nonetheless. They don't care. They're saying we've got all the chips right now. We're currently 6 rounds ahead of Kinguin. We can afford to lose another 2. 3, 4, 5. As long as we win the next one. Kinguin here trying to make a comeback into round 25. Space Soldiers, 15 rounds on the board, advantage over to them. This is also their map. Zantaris here going to be holding down Miku's position. If he pushes in towards Boiler, I'd hope he'd check. Kallax spraying through corridor, not going to be connecting with anything though. Looks like Miku going to go face on with Zantaris. He has to pick this position. If he doesn't, he's going to be failing. He looks up, takes him down as well. Doesn't Zantaris missing his shots too much? He's going to drop the player down to 29 HP. The trade comes in. Despy going to be able to take down Sparrow. The grenade coming in. That was actually an incendiary grenade. Takes Mihu down to 28. Not being too effective. Still does some damage. We're going to be on a 4-on-4 situation. Despy down to 5 HP. Whilst Mihu's on 28. Four and four, and currently they're facing up in a 4-versus-3 situation. This could easily go over into the favor of Space Soldiers. And look at that, as I say that, Kallax takes down Mihu. Favor is now over towards the side of Space Soldiers, but it's going to get traded up. The AWPer is going to get dropped. The push comes in. Kallax is there waiting for them to push. He's got the angle, but Raylan, he's going to get the drop. And look at this double kill come from Kallax. And lovely 3k. That's a monster kill. Godlike. Once again, using those two same quotes, but what a fantastic game from the Turkish team, Space Soldiers, winning their map out against Kinguin, who've proven pretty difficult on this map in the past. So that's going to be the first game in this series, 1-0 in favor of Space Soldiers. We're going to be going into the second map, and that's going to be on Cobblestone. I'm really, really excited for that map. We should see who's going to be able to win that up. I'll update the scoreboard. We'll flick onto this for a while, flick back into the next map. Thank you very much for the host, Face It. Make sure to go check them out. Make sure to check me out as well. My Twitter link has been getting spammed into chat for you guys to go follow, or even just follow this channel. I will be doing all the ECS games possible, not the NA ones. Goes on going into late night a little bit too much, apart from Friday night. Moving in though.